Autoline Daily is brought to you by Bridgestone, passion for excellence.
This is Autoline Daily for Friday the 13th of August 2010, and now the news. We're learning more about Ed Whitacre's decision to step down as chairman of General Motors. Bloomberg reports that GM's board wanted Whitacre to stay on for a few more years. As GM prepared its IPO or stock offering, investment firms wanted to know the company's long-term succession plans. Now they know. Or do they? Daniel Akerson, who replaces Whitacre, is an unknown quantity in the auto industry. While well-known in investment banking circles, Akerson has no operations experience in an industrial corporation. And yet, now he's in charge of all operations at GM. At 61 years old, he's likely to work at GM for only 4 years at the most. And it doesn't sound like he's got the backing of the people who form the core automotive group at GM. The Detroit Free Press reports that former Vice Chairman Bob Lutz says that Akerson, and I quote, will need to temper his preconceived notions with a willingness to listen to those who have transformed GM from a product and marketing standpoint. Doesn't exactly sound like a ringing endorsement, does it? Here's my Autoline insight. Ed Whitacre is smart to step down right now. He can declare victory and ride out of town as a hero, or at least as a hero in his own mind. While GM is making good progress, it's by no means out of trouble. Whitacre's decision to keep Opel may come back to haunt GM. Moreover, it looks like car sales could be slowing down in the American market, which could stop GM's recovery in its tracks. By stepping down now, Ed Whitacre is getting, while the getting is good. 2009 was a turbulent year for the auto industry, and especially for GM and Chrysler. Aside from filing for bankruptcy, one of the biggest challenges they faced involved reducing their dealer count in the U.S. According to the Detroit News, a record number of stores closed last year, 1,603 of them. But that number is down this year. So far, only 258 dealerships have closed. That leaves around 18,000 of them, compared to nearly 25,000 a decade ago. But of course, more will close as Ford winds down Mercury. The closures are tough for people and communities, but Ward's reports that GM and Chrysler could now be in a sweet spot for the number of dealerships they have. The survivors will be a lot more profitable. Infiniti just announced its new in-house performance division called IPL, which is short for Infiniti Performance Line. The first vehicle to get tweaked is the G37 Coupe. The car gets new front and rear fascias, redesigned sill moldings, and a rear spoiler. The computer controlling its 3.7-liter V6 is retuned to optimize the air-fuel ratio and raise the redline. It now tops out at 7,400 RPM. The engine breathes through a new high-flow dual exhaust system with 30% less back pressure than the base G car. Output is 348 horsepower and 276 pound-feet of torque, gains of 18 and 6, respectively. As you'd expect, the car also gets an upgraded suspension system. Yesterday, Ford auctioned off a number of its concept cars in order to raise money for charity. According to Ward's, 18 concept cars from Ford, Lincoln, and Mercury were auctioned off to benefit the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation and the Detroit area's Children's Center of Wayne County. This is the second time Ford's done this. The first was back in 2002. The company says it plans to do more of the same in the future, but it's not going to auction off everything because it wants to preserve at least some of its history. One leading indicator of where the economy is headed in the U.S. is the sale of large trucks, and things seem to be headed in the right direction. According to Ward's, sales of big trucks in July were close to 19,000 units, which is over a 12% gain compared to last year. All groups saw sales increase except for Class 4 and Class 7. For the year, big truck sales are up 10% compared to 2009. Hey, could it really be possible to simply bolt a new fuel injection system on an engine and be able to meet the strictest fuel economy standards? Coming up after the break, we'll be talking with a company that says it can do just that.
Introducing Bridgestone's third generation of run flat tires with groundbreaking new Bridgestone technologies. Bridgestone run flat tires offer improved ride comfort, lower rolling resistance, and improved wear while giving you the peace of mind and comfort you need.
Transonic Combustion is a company that's invented a new type of fuel injection system that can make a gasoline engine get the same kind of fuel economy as a diesel. Of course, all kinds of companies are making claims about their breakthrough, but when I saw that former GM Vice Chairman Bob Lotz, former Delphi Vice Chairman Don Runkel, and private equity honcho Vinod Khosla are on the board of Transonic, I knew we had to learn more about it. On Autoline After Hours last night, we had Chris DeBoer on the show. He's the head of R&D for Transonic, and he spent his entire career developing engines. Here's a clip from that show.
As you say, there are many technologies that come to the foreground, and you look at them and go, no, that's in the trash can. This one's been around long enough. We've got enough data. We have designs. We have experimental information. And when Bob Lotz took a look at it, he just went, wow. You know, I need to be part of that action. And here he is, and Don Runkel's the same. It's a, you know, this isn't a 10-minute wonder. It's a breakthrough technology. You know, as I said, I've been in engines for 25 years, and you know, you see, you know, what percent here, percent there. This is just a bump in the road. This is like, whoa, 15, 20, 25%, and it's real.
You can catch the entire show on the John's Journal section of our website. And don't forget that next Wednesday night, August 18th, Autoline After Hours will be webcasting live from the Woodward Avenue Dream Cruise, the largest automotive event in the world. And if you'd like to swing by our broadcast booth that night, please do. We'll be at the Balmoral Center building at Woodward and Normandy. If you've got a classic car or any kind of interesting car to show off, bring it by as well. But we need you to pre-register it. Check out the John's Journal section of our website at www.autolinedetroit.tv to get all the info. And that is it for today's report on the top news in the global automotive industry. Thanks for watching. We'll see you Monday.